Following is the P&L account of Mr. Patel of an export Mr. Patel, an exporter and importer for the year ending 31st March 2020. His business is export and import. Okay. So accordingly, we will decide which expense or which income is disallowed. Okay. These are debit side, these are expenses. On the credit side, we have so many incomes, and there are two adjustments. Depreciation allowed as per IT rules is 62 lakhs. Allowed word is used. So first we have to disallow the old depreciation which is available in the P&L, 3 lakhs. First it will be disallowed, and allowable is 62 lakhs. Salaries and wages include salary to proprietor, 3 lakhs, which is always disallowed. Calculate income from business or profession for the assessment year 1920 relevant to assessment year 2021. Shall we begin? Yes. Shall we start?
Yes, okay. Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Write down SSC, Mr. Patel. Legal status, individual. Previous year, assessment year, PAN card number. Write down, be fast. Next. Next we have statement heading, computation of income from business or profession. Computation of income from business or profession. Okay. Now, first, net profit as per P&L account. Always remember, we have to start with the net profit as per P&L account. It is available in the P&L. See, net profit 1 crore. 86 lakhs 10,000. Please don't do any mistake while writing the figures. Note your figures properly and then write. It is 1 crore 86 lakhs 10,000. 1861 and 4 times 0. Okay, it is 1 crore 86 lakhs 10,000. Now put a new heading, add expenses disallowed, and underline that. Add expenses disallowed, underline that. Now it is to be located on the two sides, one on the debit side and another on the adjustments. Another will be in the adjustments. So first on the debit side, can you see the first item on the debit side, opening stock? Is it related to the business? Do we need to disallow? We need to disallow? No,
no,
because
ma'am.
It is related to business. Very good. Purchases. The items that I want to export, first I need to purchase. So I'm purchasing from domestic, matlab from India, and I'm purchasing from another countries also, that is imports. Is it related to the business? Purchase.
Yes.
Yes, it is related to the business, so leave it as it is. Custom duty paid on import, of course, if you are importing, so you have to pay custom duty. So is this expense related to the business?
Yes, ma'am, related.
Okay. Yes, ma'am, related to business.
Okay, so we have to do nothing. Salaries and wages. Let's leave adjustments. We will come to adjustments. But as of now, salaries and wages, is it related to business?
Related.
Yes, ma'am, related to business.
Yes. Related means we will not disallow. Okay. Rent for bonded warehouse. You have taken a bonded warehouse where you keep those goods that you purchase. Okay. So you have to pay the rent. Yes, related to the business. Because until you take a warehouse and keep those goods safe and maintained till the time of selling those goods in the market, how will you be able to maintain those goods? No, you have to take warehouse. You have to purchase warehouse. So you are taking warehouse on the rent. and in that warehouse the goods are kept. Okay, the goods are maintained till we sell those goods in the market. Okay, so warehouse rent is related, this expense is related to the business. Interest on capital, will you tell me, it is to be disallowed or not disallowed?
Disallowed.
Very good. So interest on capital disallowed. Write down first item on in expenses disallowed this way, huh? Expenses disallowed, the first item is interest on capital. Interest on capital. Should I write it? Should I make it? Or you are doing it? Is it comfortable?
I'm doing
it. Okay. Okay. So write down add expenses disallowed ke niche. Interest on capital. It is the first item that we are going to disallow. Write down interest on capital, inner column 20 lakhs. Okay, next item. Next expense, shipping, freight and documentation. Is it related to your business?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so leave it. Depreciation. We have a adjustment related to depreciation. So we will have to hold
this
point. Okay, we will do it little later on when adjustments will come. Okay, RDD. RDD, what we need to do with RDD?
Ma'am, disallow.
Very good. Always disallow. RDD will always be disallowed because it is reserved. It may or may not occur in the future. Okay. So write down RDD. Next item in the expenses disallowed, RDD. And the amount is 3,09,000 inner column. Please note, you have to write proper figures. If you miss even one of the zeros, it will be wrong then. The answer will be wrong. 3,09,000 is your RDD. Debit side is over.
Yeah.
Debit side is over. Where shall I come to now?
Yes, ma'am.
Where shall I?
Adjustment.
Very good. Very good. Adjustment. The first adjustment is depreciation allowed as per IT income tax rules amounted to rupees 62 lakhs. Okay. So this is allowed. So what shall be disallowed first? What shall be disallowed?
I'm Joe D.I. question.
Depreciation of
debit side. Old depreciation. Old depreciation which is given in the P&L should be disallowed. Go to expenses disallowed where you are standing. Okay, this is the heading of expenses disallowed where we are right now. Write down depreciation. Inner column 3 lakhs. Inner column 3 lakhs. This is the first step. We need to disallow the older amount of the depreciation, the old amount of depreciation. And the old amount is 3 lakhs. And which amount has to be allowed? 62 lakhs. So we will do it. Wait. We have not come to the point of expenses allowable. No. We are on the point of expenses disallowed. So how much is disallowed? 3 lakhs. That's it. Now wait. Next adjustment. Next adjustment is salaries and wages include salary to proprietor Mr. Patel. Salary to proprietor. Always, you tell me, always
disallowed.
Very good. 3 lakhs rupees. Write down in the expenses disallowed salary to proprietor. Inner column 3 lakhs. So I hope debit side and adjustments are done. Both the sides are done.
Yes.
If both the sides are done, then give me the total of the inner column. What is the total of the
20,
inner column?
29,09,000.
It is to be called as 29,09,000.
9,000, yes.
Yes. It is 29,09,000. Okay. Is it okay with everybody? The same answer, 29,09,000. Look at the solution part. They have calculated the same figure, 29,09,000 in the outer column. Okay. Now come to the next heading, less expenses allowable. The way I have written, see the highlighted part. Less expenses allowable. Underline that heading. Now tell me, where do I need to find this particular heading? Where do I need to find? Only in the adjustment. Very good.
Adjustments.
Only in the adjustments. Look at the first adjustment. He says depreciation allowed as per IT rules amounted to rupees 69. Is it allowable? Is it allowable?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, it is allowed. Allowed means this is the item that I need to show in this particular heading of expenses allowable. Write down depreciation allowed. Depreciation allowed. Is this the only amount that we need to show? This is the only adjustment, na? Because the second adjustment we had to disallow. Second adjustment is related to expenses disallowed, not allowed. So allowed is only
yes,
one.
Ma'am.
Allowed is only one. That is 62 lakhs. So you can write the figure in the outer column directly. The way I have written in the previous question. See here. Here you have to write 62 lakhs in the brackets. Why in the brackets? Because it is to be deducted. Less.
Less, ma'am.
Yes. It is less expenses allowable. Therefore, 62 lakhs in the outer column. In the brackets. Okay. Adjustments done. Now, third heading. Third heading is the one that I'm highlighting. The one that I'm highlighting. See? Less incomes not to be shown. Or you can say less incomes related to other heads. Less incomes related to other heads. Okay. We will check it on the two sides. We will check this item on the two sides. One is on the
yes.
One is on the credit side,
and
another in the adjustment. Very good. Very good. So one by one. Let us start with credit side first, and then we will shift to adjustment. Let us start with credit side. Sales. Is it related to the business? Sales. Domestic
yes,
means
ma'am.
India. If within India, and export means outside India. Is it related to your business?
Yes,
yes, because your business
yes,
is export and import. He's exporter and importer. Therefore, this particular sales is also related to the business. Closing stock. Is it related to the business?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, this is domestic. This is export. Okay. Discounts and rebates earned. Discounts and rebates earned. Tell me. Is it related to business? Discount earned?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, very good. While purchasing, see, you were purchasing, no? Goods. You were purchasing goods. When you were purchasing, you got a discount of rupees 120,000. So that is your income. And it is related to business because you are purchasing goods and you are receiving discount. Therefore, it is related to your business income. It is income and it is related to the business. Therefore, leave it. Don't do anything. Okay, dividend from Indian companies. Is it related to your business?
No.
No, because always
no,
remember. Yes, always remember. Dividend from any type of shares comes from another head. That is income from other sources. It is income. I know it is income. But it is not income from business. It is not your business to purchase the shares and earn the dividend. It is not your business. It is side income, extra income. That is income from other sources. So you need to discard this amount, 60,000. Write down. Where you are? You are on the heading of less incomes not to be shown. So you will write the first point in dividend from Indian companies. Inner column, 60,000. Dividend from Indian companies. Inner column 60,000. Inner column, huh? Next, receipt. Receipt means income. Here, receipt means income. So, buy income from HUF. HUF is Hindu Undivided Family Business. Tell me, if you have earned any income from Hindu Undivided Family Business, is it your business? Tell me, come on. Yes, is it related to your business? No, very good. It is really, it is not because your business is not involved in HUF. Okay, your business is export and import, na? Exporter, he is exporter and importer. Therefore, anything apart from that will be counted as extra income. 1,40,000 less. That means less incomes not to be shown. 1,40,000 will be shown here. See, yahan par. Less incomes not to be shown ke under. Received from HUF, 1,40,000. Next. Be very careful. Huh? Buy gifts from supplier. Supplier means to whom you have to pay. From whom you are purchasing your goods. Known as supplier. Buy gifts from supplier for lifting goods for export. You got a gift from supplier. Because you are exporting the goods, no? So you got a gift from supplier. 2 lakhs. Is it related to the business? Is it related to... Yes. Kiran, it is related to the business, beta. Why it is related to business? Because it is received not from relatives. It is not related to gift from relatives. It is gift from supplier. Supplier is your businessman, no? See, if supplier is not there, from whom you will purchase the goods? आप किससे गुड्स खरीदेंगे? क्योंकि सप्लायर है तभी तो आप गुड्स खरीद रहे हो. ये देखो परचेज कर रहे हो. यू आर परचेजिंग गुड्स बिकॉज देयर इज अ सप्लायर. सो सप्लायर इज अल्टीमेटली इनडायरेक्टली रिलेटेड टू बिजनेस, नो? सो देयरफॉर गिफ्ट फ्रॉम सप्लायर इज ऑल्सो बिजनेस इनकम बिकॉज द गिफ्ट इज रिसीव्ड फ्रॉम पर्सन हु इज रिलेटेड टू बिजनेस. देयरफॉर द इनकम विल ऑल्सो बी रिलेटेड टू द बिजनेस. इज इट क्लियर किरण? किरण बेटा क्लियर है? इट इज बिजनेस इनकम. ओके नेक्स्ट. यस ओके नेक्स्ट. बाय प्राइस फ्रॉम कस्टमर्स फॉर प्रॉम्प्टनेस. नाउ यू वर वेरी गुड फॉर द कस्टमर्स. देयरफॉर कस्टमर्स गॉट वेरी हैप्पी एंड कस्टमर्स गेव यू द प्राइस ऑफ ₹3 lakhs. सो इज इट योर बिजनेस इनकम? Is it related to your business income? Come on, tell me fast.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, it is related because it is received from the customers and customers are directly related to the business. Otherwise, whom you will sell goods to? Okay. Agar customers nahi honge, toh how will you, to whom will you sell the goods? There are customers and therefore you are able to sell your goods. And it is the price from the customers. Okay. So it is related to the business. Don't do anything then if it is related to the business. Okay. Family pension from wife's employer. See, Mr. Patel's wife was working in a company. And because now wife is no more. She has died. Okay. And if she has died, her husband will receive pension. Her husband will receive pension from the wife's employer. No? Correct? So wife is dead. Now wife's employer will pay family pension to Mr. Patel because wife is not there. See, family pension means because wife is not there, therefore family pension is received by Mr. Patel. Otherwise, if it was the second case, like if wife was there, then she would have taken the pension and it was named as pension only. It would have been named as only pension, not family pension. If it is family pension, then it is understood that wife is no more. Because wife is dead and therefore family pension comes into picture. And now family pension means because wife is not there, husband will receive family pension from the employer. Whose employer? Wife's employer. Tell me, is it business income? Is it your business to receive family pension?
No, ma'am.
No, it is not business. Of course, it is understood. Very good answer. It is not my business income. My business is to export and import the goods. But this family pension, which I'm receiving from wife's employer, is not my business income. 48,000. Come on. write down here. Family pension. In this heading, incomes not to be shown. We are on the heading of incomes not to be shown, less. So we will write here family pension from wife's employer, inner column 48,000. Inner column 48,000. Now tell me the next item. Free samples received from indirect exporters. There are exporters also in the market. I have received from them free samples. Free samples means once I am satisfied by using it, I will sell it in the market then. It is known as free sample. Free sample means I'm giving it to you for free. Use it and tell me if you are satisfied, then you purchase the another item for the price. So free samples means free cost. That means you don't have to pay for it. So that is your income, 14 lakhs, because you're not paying. So it becomes your profit, no? You are receiving free samples from your exporter. Tell me, is it business? Is it related to the business? Is it related?
Yes,
yes, it is definitely related to the business. Okay, next. Then don't do anything if it is related to the business. Cash compensatory subsidy. You must know this, that government always gives subsidies to those who are exporting the goods to the another countries. So this is subsidy that I have received. So is it related to my business?
Yes.
Yes. Because I'm exporter and therefore government gives me subsidy. Okay. It is cash compensation, that is government is giving me 7,80,000. Okay. And that is known as subsidy. Subsidy is given to exporters. Okay. And therefore it is related to the business because I'm exporter. The SSC is an exporter. It is related to the business. Next. Buy custom duty drawback after export formalities. Drawback means I have received the refund of custom duty after export formalities. After exporting the goods to another countries, I have drawn back. I have received. Drawn back means I have received it back. The custom duty expenses I have received means it is my income. If it is my income, you tell me it is. Is it related to your business?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, definitely. Because after once I export and after when I fill all the formalities, I will receive custom duty. So it is related to export, no? So it is related to your business. Therefore, if it is related to your business, you don't have to do anything. Okay, buy sale of import license. Now you have an import license, you are selling it to somebody else. You tell me, is it your business income?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, because import license means you are an exporter and importer. And because you have the license, only then you are eligible to sell, export and import, no? And that particular license is sold to somebody else. So that is business income, of course. This is my business income. Sell off import license is my business income. Therefore, now how many items you have written in this heading? In this heading?
Ma'am, three.
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 Add on all the three items and tell me the total in the outer column.
Ma'am, 2,48,000.
2,48,000. It should match with this. Yes, it matches. You are right. 2,48,000. See the highlighted part? But you have to put this amount in the bracket. Put this amount in the bracket. Also, less depreciation. We have written, no, depreciation allowable. 62 lakhs. That also amount, we have to put it in the bracket. Now, the last heading. The last heading is incomes to be shown. Incomes to be shown. It is only and only available in the
Adjustments.
Very good.
Adjustments,
it is only
ma'am.
And only available in the adjustments. So look at the adjustments. Come on, tell me, is there any adjustment related to income?
No.
No, because first adjustment was for depreciation, that is my expense. And second adjustment was salary and wages, that is also my expense. But I am on the heading of incomes. very important. Incomes. I'm not looking out for expenses. I'm looking out for incomes to be shown. So in the adjustment, no adjustment is given for the incomes. Therefore, in the outer column, you can simply put nil. Just as I have done here. Now, can you tell me the final total? Please don't forget this net profit. Net profit. Then you have to add on expenses disallowed. Then you have to deduct expenses allowable. Then you have to deduct expenses related to other heads. And then you have to add incomes to be shown. Tell me the final total.
Ma'am, 1,50,71,000.
Okay. Is it this one? 1,50,71,000? Is this the right figure?
Ma'am.
So this is your final answer. 1,50,71,000 is your final net taxable income from business or profession. Is it clear to everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good. See, Mr. Prabhakaran furnishes you the following information for computing his business income. There are expenses and incomes given here in the P&L, and there are adjustments also. So we will begin with with the question. I mean solution part. We will read it and simultaneously we will do our solution. Start. Write down SSC Mr. Prabhakaran. Legal status individual. Previous year 2019-20, assessment year 2021, and your PAN card number is nil. Okay, shall we start? Write down the heading. Computation of income from business or profession. Computation of income from business or profession. So we will start with three columns, particulars, inner column and outer column. I hope you all are writing. Are you guys writing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Write down. First, always we have to start with net profit. Write down net profit as per P&L account. It is 2,40,000 in the outer column. 2,40,000 in the outer column. Now write down the first heading, add expenses disallowed. There are four headings. First is add expenses disallowed. Underline that. Tell me, there are two different sides that we need to find it on. So first side is debit and the second is?
Adjustment.
Very good. So first is debit, office expenses. Tell me disallowed or not disallowed. Come on, be quick. Office expenses. Do I need to disallow?
No, ma'am.
No.
Because it is related to business. Telephone deposit, yes, OIT scheme. This is some scheme, but this is telephone deposit. Is it related to business? Of course it is related to business.
Yes, ma'am, related to business.
So leave it. Staff health insurance, paid in cash. It is staff health insurance. Staff. Is it related to business? Yes, related to business. Next, salary. Is it related?
Yes.
Yes. Depreciation related?
No, ma'am.
No. Why no? Depreciation is related to business, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Traveling. Is it related to business? Traveling expenses. Is it related to business? Yes, it is related to business. Next, loss of cash by theft. Aapki business mein jo cash padi thi uski chori ho gayi. इसे कहते हैं एम्बर्समेंट, कैश एम्बर्समेंट, एंड इट इज रिलेटेड टू द बिजनेस बिकॉज ऑफिस के कैश की चोरी हुई ना, घर की थोड़ी, ये ऑफिस में जो कैश पड़ी थी चोरी हो गई, सो इट इज रिलेटेड टू बिजनेस, इट इज नॉट घर का कैश. ओके, नेक्स्ट, एक्सपेंसेस ऑन दिवाली, इज इट रिलेटेड टू बिजनेस? ऑफिस में दिवाली का खर्चा नहीं होता है?
होता है मैम.
हाँ, तो फिर ये बिजनेस से रिलेटेड है, अगर कुछ बोला नहीं है.
ओके मैम,
अभी के लिए तो रिलेटेड है. इंटरेस्ट, आप जो बिजनेस के लिए लोन लेते हो उस पे इंटरेस्ट भरते हो ना, व्हेनेवर यू टेक लोन फॉर बिजनेस.
यस मैम.
सो यू पे इंटरेस्ट, नो? एज ऑफ नाउ इट इज रिलेटेड, एज ऑफ नाउ इट इज रिलेटेड टू बिजनेस. ओके, नाउ एडजस्टमेंट्स आर डन, नाउ वी नीड टू स्टडी. I mean, we need to look at, sorry, debit side is done. Now we need to look at adjustments. First is salary include 10,800 paid to Mr. Balan out of India. That means Balan is not residing in India. He lives in outside India, on which no tax has been deducted at source. Now, salary, come to salaries. Salaries is 35,000. Out of 35,000, 10,000 is 800 to 10,800 is paid to Mr. Balan, who is not living in India. Okay, that's okay. If any person does not live in India, you can pay.